Hi folks, Tony Fraser here again. Every once in a while you do hear of prospectors finding the odd meteorite every now and again. So I thought I'd give you a little bit of a rundown of what they look like and what to expect if you actually find one. So I've actually got three different meteorites here on the table. This one I actually found myself out prospecting in Western Australia. I actually recognised it first before I waved the detector over it, but it does give a very good signal. And even though at first glance it might just look like a piece of ironstone, I could tell, apart from the fact it was ironstone all over the ground, I could tell that this one was a meteorite straight away. It has a very distinctive kind of form and shape, this dark kind of a chocolatey patina to it, which is the oxidisation of the meteorite as it's been sitting on the surface for maybe several thousands of years. Just in contrast, this is a meteorite I bought. It fell in Libya just a year or so ago. It's actually the same composition of meteorite, but you can see this actually got a darker, kind of blacker, more kind of glassy kind of skin to it. So that's what this meteorite would have looked like fresh, straight out of the atmosphere thousands of years ago when it first fell, but as it's been exposed to water and weathering, it's kind of oxidized and rusted. Both of these are actually stony meteorites, a relatively common meteorite. They will give you a signal with your metal detector, and they are actually quite commonly found and mistaken for hot rocks and discarded. This little one, this is from a classic locality in Northern Territory, at Henbury. This is an old specimen found many years ago. It's an iron nickel meteorite, so it's very strongly magnetic, and this will absolutely scream on your metal detector. There's been a few finds of iron nickel meteorites around Australia over the years with people prospecting for gold. But yeah, this one, very magnetic, and yeah, this one will absolutely scream, as I said. So. There's a few meteorites for you. Keep your eye out. Just don't assume your hot rocks are hot rocks. Have a good look at them. They usually do have distinctive patterns and shapes to them. But yeah, keep an eye out just in case. You never know. And some can be worth as much, if not more, than gold. So well worth looking for. Good luck out there in the fields. Thank you very much for listening.